Transcription is at the heart of every Descript project. Every new project will begin with you importing a video or audio file, which Descript automatically transcribes. Watch on to see how automatic transcription works for imported files. First, we'll go through importing single files, then we'll cover creating multitrack sequences. First, open or create a new project. Now, drag and drop your video or audio file into the script panel. This prompt will appear. If it's the first time you're importing a file, Descript will ask you to set your default transcription language. Check Always Ask Before Transcribing if you plan on transcribing files in multiple languages. You can always adjust your default language later from your app preferences, located here. When this prompt appears, enter the speaker's name. If you have more than one speaker in the file, click the speaker name box and set the number of speakers to detect and label those speakers. If there's a bunch of people talking in your file, we recommend selecting Identify Speakers here. This feature lets you listen to portions of your file and type in the name of the speaker or select the speaker's name from the drop-down menu. When you're done, click Close and wait for Descript to transcribe your file. If you have multiple files from an interview or recording session, you can take advantage of Descript's multi-track sequence feature. This is a sort of virtual container that groups together separate speaker files for ease of editing. With your project open, drag and drop your files into the script panel at the same time. Label each of your speaker files with the name of the speaker. Be sure to do this now, prior to transcription, to keep your transcript organized. Then, make sure Combine Files into a Multitrack Sequence is selected. When you're done, click Done and wait for Descript to transcribe your files. Once the files are transcribed, you can edit the transcript like you would if it contained a single file. To find your sequence or edit it directly, right-click in the script panel or down here on the timeline and choose Edit Sequence. You can also use the keyboard shortcuts Shift-Command-O or Shift-Control-O. Double-clicking the timeline also brings you to the sequence.